Hello, I'm Ben with NTS Tire, and with me today is Ryan and Stuart from our changeover team. We're here to talk about ultra-wide LSW tires by Titan. They're one of the hottest technologies in ag tires right now, and in just a few minutes, you'll know why. We're gonna dig into what farmers are experiencing firsthand out in the field, look at some of the trials, comparing their performances, and let you know where they might shine and where you might be better off going with something else. We've had two extremely wet harvest seasons in a row in the upper Midwest. Mud has motivated a number of farmers to switch their combines from duals to 1250s or 1400 LSW singles. Stuart, what have your customers had to say about LSWs and how they handle the mud?
Well, we've had the privilege of visiting several of our customers that have made the swap from the factory duals over to these large singles. Got one customer I'm thinking of particularly in southern Minnesota, Mountain Lake area, that made the swap, and he is very happy with them. He's running two combines side by side. He's got the two 690s, John Deere 690s, and there's some spots he went into with his factory duals, and he backed out of, and he went in there with his 1400s, and he said he walked right through it. Also, with his factory duals, he was experiencing rim cracking and bolts busting.
So why would he have cracking issues with duals versus these LSW singles?
With the factory dual setup, you've got them high offset rims, and when you got the center offset beyond the tire, so you got your tire and then you got your rim being offset beyond it, acts as a lever really. It puts a lot of stress on those centers and also on the bolts, and that's why a lot of people are experiencing broken bolts, cracked centers. We've replaced several of them on your S-Series combines as well as 9000 series. So when you go to the large single tire, the center plate is dead center in the tire. So you've got vertical load bearing instead of that twisting or that side-to-side tension. It's all vertical load bearing. So he thinks he's going to experience a lot less cracking and broken bolts. And also, he doesn't have to pull the dual off every so often to inspect the inner rim because you can't see it without removing the outer dual. You know, you got just one tire on there, you can see the whole inside and out. Another customer visited up in Stuart, Minnesota area, had a 9870 John Deere, and he had the aftermarket 710 38 duals. He said a lot of things similar to that other customer in Mountain Lake, but he also said that he thinks the auto steer works a lot better. He was having some issues with his auto steer not working. In fact, he said it was so squirmy he would have to use his brakes to steer with his aftermarket duals on. And also, he mentioned that when he gets to a wet spot, he actually slows down. A lot of my customers mentioned that they speed up when they get to a wet spot. They'll try to push their way through it. And he said he slows down 1 mile an hour. And I think that allows the mud to flow around and the float tires to really work, to do their job, to float over top instead of pushing it through where you might get buildup in front of the tire.
Some guys are preferring the duals versus the LSWs. I know we've had one customer that preferred his duals versus the 1250 LSWs. Why would it be that he would prefer that over the single LSW?
Well, it could be largely to do with the soil type, but also it could be that his duals are sinking through the mud, through the soup, and getting to his hard pan, which would give him more stability and allow him to drive through it better. But the bad part of that is that when you get to the hard pan, he could be pushing his hard pan down, and then he's going to be creating deep ruts. He's going to be dragging a lot of mud out onto the road, with all that mud packed in there, versus the floats would, more float over top, and then, as the other customers mentioned, would clean out better and wouldn't drag as much mud out. But the particular customer that you mentioned, he said that he was experiencing a wall of mud in front of the float tire. Now, I'm not sure what he's doing when he gets to the muddy spots, if he's speeding up or slowing down. Our other customers mentioned that have had success said they slow down when they get to the muddy spots, and I think that allows the mud to flow around. And so if this customer is speeding up when he gets to the muddy spots, I would recommend that he slows down and gives that a try.
Let's move away from combines and talk about some of the other applications for ultra-wide LSWs. Ryan, in a tillage application, how do LSWs compare to traditional dual setups on four-wheel drives and front-wheel assist tractors?
Well, in the past, many customers with the standard 870-38 dual setup on the four-wheel drive have experienced a very bad power hop and road lope. Now, where these things can be fixed with precision monitoring of tire pressure, we actually have a team of experts that goes out and P-tome service, we call it, and sets these tractors up with the exact right PSI front to back. One of the problems is it can be a bit of a babysitting job depending on wet to dry, spring to fall. These need to be monitored and adjusted. As with the LSW, we obviously have two different applications in the four-wheel drive. Especially, we've got the 1250, 1400, 46 single application, the 900, 846 dual application. Either one of these applications really takes care of your power hop, road lope issues drastically, and you can typically set your PSI, and it's fairly close year-round, not something you have to spend a lot of time changing, which is nice for customers. I, in particular, had one customer pulling a scraper running on a New Holland tractor, four-wheel drive, running 870-38s, and he was experiencing bad power hop, road lope. We put on 1250, 35, 46s, took care of that problem. One thing he did say, he thought he sacrificed a little bit of traction, perhaps, with a smaller footprint in the single, but he was working a lot in urban areas, so it gave him the advantage, narrower. There again, not throwing the mud like a dual application, so he thought it outweighed what he lost in traction, but he was happy with them.
I had a customer that swapped from the 800 duals to 1400 3046 LSWs on a 9620R, pulling a large tillage equipment, and he said he had about 6 to 10% slippage, so he thought it was very comparable to what he's running, so that was good. Now on the front wheel assist, we've got a customer, and he's got a 8260R, and he switched it. He had the narrow 380 90 54s on the rear and 380 38s on the front, and he took them off and went to a 1400 rear and the 1100 fronts, and he noticed very much more traction. Of course, he had narrow duals on there, but last year he was running that tractor with the narrow tires on there, and he ended up having to park the tractor. He couldn't get through the wet spots, so with these large single LSWs, he was able to get through what he needed to this year, and he got his tillage done with his front wheel assist row crop tractor.
That's good. The field work will be coming to an end here soon, which means it's time to start thinking about next year. We have some customers who will be using the ultra-wide LSWs on their planting tractors next spring. So Ryan, how does this affect emergence and yields compared to duals?
Yeah, well, we had a privilege of working with a New Holland dealer here locally in Minnesota, and he had a customer in Canada about a T8 New Holland front wheel assist. It had the 480, 80, 50 Michelins on the rear, 420, 85, 34 Michelins on the front, dualed up. And the customer had a comparable tractor at home set up the same way, but he'd read about the LSW and wanted to try that application with the 1146 rears and 1032 fronts, and that was last spring. He took it home and used it for planting, and between the two tractors, he said the LSWs were, he felt, far more successful and better yields planting right in the track with the LSW versus what the damage the row pinch did between the tires on his other tractor. He was very happy, very impressed, said he would never run another tractor with duals versus the LSW. Just was very excited.
Titan Tire actually did a side-by-side field study with the LSWs on two New Holland tractors with Kinsey planters, 16 row. And on the first tractor, they left the factory duals on the 480, 80, 50 Michelins, and the fronts were 380, 80, 38s. And the other tractor, they took them off and put on 1100, 45, 46 single LSWs, and then on the front was a 1030 4032, and end result at the when harvest time came, they got about 5 bushels per acre more in the corn and 6 bushels per acre more in the beans. And the cost of savings was about $16 an acre per corn after figuring 10% for fuel savings as well with his LSWs. And it was about $60 per acre in the beans. Wow. And he reckons he paid off his LSWs in less than a year.
Nice. So we've seen 1250 and 1400 LSW singles perform very well on combines. They've improved handling. They've reduced compaction issues. They've helped farmers float through more mud. And farmers have also mentioned that they're cleaner on the road. They may be a solution to cracked rim issues. When it comes to pulling abilities in tillage applications, LSWs may not outperform some of the traditional dual setups, but they have held their own. And for the guys that don't want to fuss over precise ballasting and air pressure, LSWs have solved the power hop and road lope issues. For planting, Titan's side-by-side trial certainly showed some promising results with sizable yield increases and a return on investment in less than a year. Several of our customers will be using LSW singles for planting next season, so we'll have more information for you as the 2018 season gets rolling.
And by the way, February 7th, we'll be having an open house here at NTS Tire Supply, featuring a number of different experts in the field of high-performance planting traction. It'll be a great opportunity to learn about LSWs and other traction technologies for planting. Keep an eye on our website for the latest information on this event as February 7th approaches.
That's right. And if you have any questions regarding the topics discussed in this video, leave a comment or email them to info.ptk@ntstiresupply.com or call us. Stuart, Ryan, or myself, any of the guys here at NTS Tire Supply will be happy to answer any questions you may have. Also, if you have a traction topic you'd like us to cover, let us know by leaving a comment. And finally, if you like this video and you found the information useful, give us a thumbs up and please share it with others. If there's something we could do better, let us know that as well. Thanks again for watching and stay tuned for more videos from NTS Tire Supply.